This is a scatterplot of thousands of research articles that could be helpful in the fight against COVID-19, all of which were clustered, labeled, and plotted through computer code that was written by college students.
I have a different type of skill set that I can use to help in this situation. Doctors are the ones in the front lines doing a lot of work, putting themselves in danger. And maybe I can use what I know in one way, and perhaps it's going to be helpful.
It's helping engineers create artificial intelligence programs to find critical information about COVID-19 as quickly as possible.
These were ideas that were done laboriously and manually, in every past epidemic. Now we can do it in real time.
AI is already working to stop COVID-19 by tracking the spread, identifying high-risk people, and developing drugs. While a lot of this is being done by startups and tech companies, citizen scientists are now jumping in to join the fight.
Scientists are essentially dealing with a deluge of information.
This is Rao. He's the former president of the Association for Advancement of Artificial Intelligence.
Too many papers coming out, and just keeping up with the research is going to be very hard. We don't want to redo what somebody else has already done. We want to expand knowledge. And some areas of this certainly are life for citizen science. And that's what the Kaggle competitions typically try to exploit.
Kaggle is a platform where companies and researchers can post data for anyone to build AI and machine learning tools for data and text mining. They're set up as competitions and sometimes come with cash prizes. The dataset available on Kaggle includes 44,000 medical papers, generally about coronaviruses. So most aren't specifically about COVID-19, and the terminology across all those papers really isn't standardized. Drawing any actionable insights would be a monumental task for any human. So since time is of the essence, that's a job primed for AI. The call is for really anyone with the know-how to build AI and machine learning tools to extract information from those papers that might answer high priority scientific questions to fight COVID-19. Maxim, a college student in Maryland, answered the call.
I started it and it was my spring break. So that whole week, I would say 8 to 10 hours a day spent on this. My first question I was asked, okay, this is a lot of data. Can I do something about this so that it actually would be easier for health professionals to learn more about this?
Maxim built this tool that clusters articles based on topic and uses a technique called dimensionality reduction, which plots similarities of the publications so algorithms may be able to find connections that humans miss.
If you look at cluster number 18, you're gonna find articles about MERS. If you look at cluster 16, you're gonna find articles about the economic and social impact of coronavirus and tourism. Cluster 15 will be air and virus particles. If you search face mask filter, you're gonna see a subcluster there. This is very interesting for us, that is talking about face mask and filter. You may be able to see patterns that you wouldn't be able to see as a human because we are applying the machine learning algorithms on these kind of things.
It's too soon to say if the Kaggle competition will help lead to a breakthrough in the fight. Maxim and Rao know that AI is not perfect. Alone, it's not the answer to stopping COVID-19, or finding a vaccine, or preventing a future pandemic. But they believe this powerful technology, in conjunction with scientists' work, could help us get closer to that.
The technology is a helper. I think certainly there is a very important role AI technologies can play. The scientists are still going to be in the front lines in coming up with the vaccines, at least in the foreseeable future. But their productivity could potentially be improved.
The pandemic is, it's spreading really fast. So you need to give some, opportunity for people to help professionals specifically catch up with the research community. And they have to do it really fast. There's a lot of people with different kind of skill sets now who are able to do something with that.
Thanks for watching. If you like this story, go to our website, freethink.com. For more stories about COVID-19 and the people on the front lines fighting this global pandemic.